Hello. This video is about workflows in EspoCRM. Workflows automate your business processes in easy way. This feature is available in advanced pack. You can find it in the administration panel customization section. To create a workflow rule, you need to firstly define name, target entity, what entity type workflow is applied to, trigger type, when workflow will be triggered. Also, we can set the description, activate or deactivate the workflow, or assign it only to the portal. There are such trigger types. After record saved, triggered when a new or existing record is saved. After record created, triggered only when a new record is created. Scheduled, triggered according to the defined scheduling. You can set it up to run every day, every week, etc. This string means that this workflow will be triggered every day at midnight. Actions will be applied for records returned by specified list report, the field target report. Sequential, supposed to be run by another workflow, provides an ability to make a complex logic. Let's set the name. Rules for assigned cases. Target entity is case, and it has to be triggered after record saved. Conditions. You can specify conditions that must be met to trigger the workflow. For workflow with trigger scheduled, this panel is hidden because conditions are set in the target report. There are three sections where you can set conditions. All conditions are met. Any, at least one condition is met, and formula, conditions of any complexity in ESPO formula language. Some available conditions types are, let's select contact and status fields, for example. Changed, if the field was changed before the workflow was triggered. Not empty, if the field is set. Empty, if the field isn't set. Equals, if the field equals to specific value or value of another field. Was equal, if the field was equal to specific value before the workflow was triggered, etc. To read about formula syntax, follow this article. Remember that there shouldn't be used semicolon delimiter in the formula if you define condition. If you set a few sections, the workflow will be triggered in case if all set sections return true. A small tip, if you want something like trigger type after record updated, use after record saved and set the function entity is new with exclamation mark in the formula. Let's set conditions in all section. Status changed and status equals assigned. Actions. What to do if workflow is triggered. Let's overview available action types. Send email. It can be sent immediately or delayed for a specific interval. The system will send an email using a specified email template from the system, current user, specified email addresses, or assigned user. A recipient's email address can be taken from the target record, any related record, the current user, followers, and team users or specified. Also, you can set to store the sent email or not. Let's add an action send email to assigned user from the system. Immediately, select needed template, apply. The next item in action list is trigger another workflow. It allows to execute a sequential workflow immediately or with some delay. In the sequential workflow, you can define the condition that checks whether specific fields were changed since the parent workflow was triggered by using changed and was equal condition types. An example of usage of this is checking the task for completing 3 days after the assignment. If not, notify the manager with an email. Sequential workflow checks if status is not equal to closed and send email. Apply. The next item in action list is create entity. The system will create the new record of any entity type. You need to set needed fields of the new entity. Also, it's possible to define the formula to calculate fields. Also, you can create related entity. The system will create the records related to the target record. Like in previous action type, you need to define fields of this new entity. Let's create related task. Set the fields name, field case name, date start today, due date today plus 3 days, assigned user, field case assigned user. Update entity allows to change specific fields of the target record. Formula editor is available as well. Let's add to Teams the default team of assigned user. Apply. Also, you can use this action type, for example, in the scheduled workflow with scheduling for every day, for updating day counter field or checking for expiration. Scheduled workflow will update all cases which are met in target report. The next is update related entity. Allows to change specific fields of the related record or records. As you can see, it's possible to define the formula to calculate fields to create entity, update entity, create related entity, and update related entity. For the last two, for related entity, to access attributes of target entity, you should use the function target entity attribute. For example, name assigned target entity attribute name. To access attributes of target entity that was set before the workflow was triggered, use the function target entity attribute fetched. Create notification action. Allows to notify specify users, team members, followers, or users related to the target entity with some message. It's possible to use placeholders in the message template. Entity, target record, user, current user. For example, notify all team members about assigned case in system, recipient, team users, message, case entity name is assigned to entity assigned username. Apply. Also, you can link with or unlink from another specified entity with corresponding items in action list. Make followed. Forces specific users to follow the target entity, if empty value, or a specified related entity. Let's make Brandon Lewis following target case. Apply. Run service action. Allows to execute a specific PHP code. The link you see is the link to the guide on how to make the service method available in user interface. Apply assignment rule. Assigns the target record to some user by the distribution rule. There are two available rules, round robin and least busy. Round robin users are chosen from the top to the bottom of the list team and then starting again. Least busy. A user who has fewer assigned records will be chosen for the assignment. For a least busy distribution, a list report determines what records will be taken into account to calculate the number of assigned records. For example, for cases, we need to take only records with active status. Apply. That's it. Thank you. Bye.